We all know that phones go beyond just calls these days. The problem is, now we don't have enough hands to juggle everything that we use them for. So Allie is here to help with her DIY phone stand, which is pretty fantastic, let me tell you.
I know, I love them. I just think they're so cute. It was actually inspired by my husband. So he does this thing for me every night where he like takes my phone cord off the floor and he puts it under my water cup next to the bed so I can like easily charge my phone at night, which is so sweet of him.
Oh my gosh, that is adorable.
So I thought there's gotta be like a cuter stand and like thing for him to put my cord under or like by my bed for me.
That just would be perfect.
Yes, and it happens to be our 3-year anniversary today. So I wanna say happy anniversary to my husband, 3 years today. So this is inspired by him.
Yes.
And honestly, these phone stands, they're really, really popular right now. They can be very expensive, and I thought this is a really inexpensive way to like create your own.
And very unique, too.
Yes.
Like a lot of the stands kind of look alike, not like this. Okay, so let's get started. What's the first thing we need to do?
Okay, so what you're going to do, you want to get your clay. So this is Sculpey. Yeah. I like using this. I mean, it's a baked clay, so you're going to bake this.
Okay.
You could use, you know, a different kind of clay, an air dry clay if you wanted to, but I like Sculpey just because it comes in a lot of colors.
Okay.
So it comes in like the usually these 2-ounce packets right here.
Yeah.
You're gonna need about 8 ounces to do this
okay.
size that I'm doing. So let's say these are the 4 packs. The first thing you wanna do is combine them all. And you really wanna combine them well. So first, just kind of push them all together.
Okay, and did you use 2 different colors here and mix them up, or? Okay.
Yes, absolutely, Cameron, thank you. So to do the marbling effect, you just do 2 different colors and just kind of like, fold them together.
This is pretty cool.
Yeah, I recently actually did this. I did these like little ring stands on the show recently
and did this same
technique. Yes, you can check that out online if you want to see that. So once you like push them all together, you want to then use even this is a piece of craft wood that I'm going to use for the stand.
Keep
the plastic on so it doesn't get dirty, and then use it to really just push all the clay together. And the reason we're doing this is we don't want any like
air bubbles in there. That's the key, right?
And that really just get your shoulders in. This will be your workout for
the
day.
It's almost therapy too. Like you get to mash the clay together, then you get to push it down. It's fantastic.
Exactly. Getting so you'll have this. And
okay, good. You're gonna keep going. And now obviously you're gonna roll it out, but you wanna flatten it out a little bit with the board first before
rolling? It can be just like this and then go right to rolling. I mean,
okay.
You can flatten out with the board first. Whatever you do to get a shape that is big enough to put your bowl over. So
okay.
This is where we use a bowl.
And the bowl, the idea is obviously to cut out a perfect circle. That's what we're using it for.
Exactly.
Okay.
So any bowl that you have, the only thing you have to worry about when choosing your bowl is that your craft wood has to be like able to fit inside the bowl, the craft wood that you're going to use for this project. You also want to make sure there's at least a 1/2 inch on either side, but you could use a bigger bowl for this. The bowl could come out to here. You just want to make sure it's not smaller.
And you'll see why in a minute.
Yes.
We'll get
so
to that
we'll take our bowl and you just put it over the Sculpey and push down to get your circle. And then you're just going to take an X-Acto knife and just cut all the way around your bowl. I think it's kind of maybe cut, but I'm going to go around just to make sure. Cut all the way around. There we go.
And that way you get your fantastic perfect circle, like you mentioned.
Yes.
And now it's driving it in there.
Okay, there you go. So then you peel this up once you do that.
Okay, so now do you leave it in a perfect circle like that? By the way, that's really impressive.
I know, right?
Or do you want to flatten the bottom off a little bit so that when it kind of when you're ready, it stands up nicely?
So you can do that, absolutely.
Yeah.
You can see on the ones over here, I actually did do that.
Oh, there you go.
But the thing is, you honestly, that gives you extra stability, but you don't actually have to, because when this is laying on the ground back, this flat surface in the back here will actually give it that stability.
Okay.
But I do like doing that, so I'm actually going to do that right now. I'm going to use this one.
Okay.
So keep the plastic on your board still. Just flatten out the bottom by doing this, easy as that.
There you go. Just take a little sliver off.
Yeah, it takes a little sliver off. I probably should have used my X-Acto knife, but I'm just going to do this for now. And then what you do is you take, again, your board. You use this guy a lot. Keep that plastic on because it's going to keep it nice.
No kidding.
You want to go to the middle part of your board first just to see where it is, and then come down just a tiny bit and push. Let me make sure I'm centered here. And push it in. And that is how you are going to get your little hole that this board is.
Do you go all the way through, or do you just kind of make an indentation and then cut it out with the? Okay,
yeah,
very good.
And then these are little tools in any like you know clay kit, sculpting kit that you use to just make sure you cut out and take out all the center. It's so easy.
I'm telling you right now. People, you guys at home, you're going to love this. We're going to have lots of viewer mail about this.
I know. Isn't it great? It's so great. So
it's
then, you just do this. As you can see, I kind of started on this side to get all of the inside out. And then you're going to bake this per the instructions on the clay kit.
Yeah, whatever type of clay you have. Okay, very good.
Yeah.
Now, believe it or not, we've used this guy a lot. We take the plastic off, and now we're really going to use it.
Exactly.
Right?
So you'll end up with this in the end. If this section in here, if you like try to put your board in and you're like, it's not fitting, all you need to do is take, I like to take a little popsicle stick and wrap it in sandpaper and then just go inside and sand it down a little bit. It's super easy, as you can see, like that. Just a little bit at a time and then keep testing your board. But if it seems right and you got it going, you just take your board, you pop it through like so. And voila.
And I'm looking at that, and I think it obviously will easily hold an iPhone, but even maybe an iPad?
Absolutely. So let's say this right here. If this was an iPad, you could just put it like this, stick it right on there. Here, I'll turn. And there's your iPad. Maybe you couldn't do it this way. If it was this way, actually, maybe it would work that way. But yeah, you could totally put an iPad. And then you can see over here, this one up here.
Yeah, what is that?
So it's a little, one, this is a like a sparkle Sculpey, which I like. But it has a like glazed look, right? I just took this stuff right here. It's like a glaze you spray over, let it dry. In about 24 hours, it's totally dry. And it gives it that nice little finished look.
Yeah, it does give it a great look. Allie, these are fantastic. I am kind of loving these right now. Go to HallmarkChannel.com, everybody, for full instructions. They will all be there.